Okay, so we're back. I think this will be take two since there's a sudden brownout. So what probable, I'll add here, what probable aromatic products would you obtain from the KMnO4 oxidation of the following substances? We start from letter A. So KMnO4 reacting with your somewhat, we will name this one. This one is a an isopropyl. See, that is a CCH3CH3. You have both CH3, so the attachment is on the carbon 2. And this one is a nitrobenzene. So a nitrobenzene, so that's an isopropyl nitrobenzene reacting with your potassium permanganate or KMnO4. So after that, we go back to our cheat sheet. You have to take note of the KMnO4. So if ever I'll be giving you this as a quiz, maybe we'll include even this word, oxidation of alkyl benzene side chain, so that you will really be directed that this is the chemical reaction that you're going to make. Because again, I'm not assuming that you will be a chemist. Our aim here is for you to know how to use this table or summary, or somehow we can understand the chemists. So it says here that reacting with your KMnO4, that's CH3. CH3 would be replaced by an O2H, meaning all those attached with this carbon. See this black here, and you also have this black here, meaning the carbon, all the attachments for your carbon would be replaced by an O2H. So if we're going to go back here, all the attachment, what is the attachment here from your carbon? We'll try to draw the attachment of your carbon there, reading from that. See, you have a CH3, you have a CH3, and you have an H. So that's what that compound looks like in terms of really evaluating or splitting this, so that it would be understandable. Okay, so meaning this 1, 2, 3 would be replaced by an carbonyl and an alcohol. So meaning reacting with your KMnO4, one of the probable products, we will just say probable because we're reading from our cheat sheet. Anyway, if you can still find from the cheat sheet another chemical reaction, just use them and probably I'll look into it. Probably you will be right. Okay, we don't have a detailed rule, or we will not be following a detailed rule. There's a detailed rule, but we will not be following that one as of now because it would be too cumbersome for a non-chemist. Okay, so it does mean from the cheat sheet that all of those will be replaced by what? A double bond oxygen and an OH. So meaning a double bond and OH, the nitro will be affected, reading from that cheat sheet. Okay, so the answer would be, of course, now you have a nitrobenzene, but this one is more famous actually. In fact, it has one name. This is a nitrobenzene. This one is a, if I'll be naming this one nitrobenzene, this one is an acid. So basically an acid is more priority in terms of a parent than your nitro. So anyway, you can go back to your carboxylic acids, how they are named, meaning, or from your benzene, you can see that this is a benzoic acid. Benzoic, so benzene, tapos you have your carbon, one carbon which is an acid, we call it a benzoic acid. So it would be harder, I think there may be naming from this, and then this would be a nitrobenzene, and there would not be an ambiguity, but I think it would be harder. Okay, so we go to the more common route, which is this one is known as a benzoic acid and this one is a nitro. So we would say 1, 2, 3. So that would be a 3. 3 nitro. Benzoic acid. Okay? That is for that. I think I have to cut first so that it would not be too long. Okay?